the outfield's fast, tornado or not.
And there's four more. Much in the same fashion that Trescothick has peppered that cover boundary all morning.
With ease. This time at Strauss.
Don't want to bowl there too often to Andrew Strauss. 50 up for England. There he goes. Really good stroke from Strauss in more ways than one. Not just that he executed the stroke very well, but it sends a signal.
Oh, that's a terrific hit. Goodness me.
Run.
That's as good as anything that he's played. My goodness.
That's the slider, and well driven by Trescothick. And that couple brings up a very nice half-century for the Somerset man. Nothing better than that played by Andrew Strauss that we've seen this morning. One more. 100 up. 100 partnership between these two left-handers.
Until that very moment. And what a wonderful change of pace that was. That's the real art of leg spinning. A really quick delivery.
Beautiful stroke, the best of the lot.
In an exceptionally strong position at lunch, 132 for one, and the weather improving. Lovely for batting.
Gorgeous shot. Now that's footwork. That's quality and that's class.
A little outside edge on 90, walks. So finally, Australia get their second wicket. It's been a long haul. It's been hard work. We're only into the second session, but they'll feel like they've been out there for a whole lot longer than that. That'll do. Whoa. That's probably a little bit of nervous energy that's allowed him to launch into that.
Out, 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 out. No doubt at all about that. That was a forward shot, but not really a convincing. Didn't really play at it confidently. And that's beautifully bowled because it left the batsman.
Well, this is the time for Australia. They can turn things around. They've got new batsmen coming to the crease. They can really attack.
Now then, there is a man down the fence. It is close to the fence. Brett Lee has got it. That was by no means an easy catch. It was swirling around, and so was he for that matter. And finally, he's got himself in a position to take it. Not quite what captain ordered.
It was a fantastic catch. It was up there for a long time. It was downwind. It looked for a second as if it was going for six.
Enough said.
It was lovely to see the ball hit off the back foot through extra cover. Stroke of a top class player.
Gee.
Good punchy hit that. Oh my goodness me.
And again, and he doesn't know where that is, but it's gone for four, it's gone for six. Well, he tucked his head in.
Oh, that's a few. Don't worry about that. No. Shane Warne shouted, catch. There's a fella in the crowd stood up to try and get it.
And that's his off century. That's beautifully played. It crashes into the boundary at cover. Andrew Flintoff, a lot's expected of him. With bat and ball, and he's got the crowd here at Edgbaston on their feet. There's another bouncer, it's in the air, it's gone for six, it's a big six, it's gone back miles.
There were a few reasons why this was such a good partnership by Peterson and Flintoff, but foremost amongst them was the fact that they worked together so well for the first time.
That's out, caught behind. It's a dangerous little time just after the break. That was a very good delivery. thick edge, and that's the end of what was a fantastic partnership. 250 wickets for Jason Gillespie. It's out, caught behind, of course he is. Up goes the finger, a huge nick there. Jones staying at the crease.
And Peterson plays another remarkable stroke. That is a very fine innings. Three knocks against Australia and 350s. He really does hit the ball well. You know, that old line about he's worth the admission money alone, he really is. Out! This time Bowden says, you got to go.
That looked as though it would have to be very, very close. It was a quicker ball, looked like the straight one.
Crikey, O'Reilly. He's got again, and he's out court. He won't have picked up too many wickets in a test match quite like that. But, English supporters might rue Peterson's adventure.
It wasn't quite off the middle of the bat from Peterson. Carriage came in, judged it well.
And that could be out. Out of the ground.
Catch.
Hey! Oh, what a reply. The slider straight out of the front of the hand.
They deceived Armisen here, got it very full. It was almost through him as he tried to play it to leg. A bit puzzled. That's a wonderful picture, that. He's bamboozled, all right. 375 for nine.
Oh.
That is a glorious strike.
Sixer! It's another good hit, is it? Not quite good enough to reach the boundary, but it does bring up England's 400.
Which came to an end soon after that, when Matthew Hoggard was LBW to Shane Warne. The ball pitching between wicket and wicket, hitting him between wicket and wicket, and Hawkeye proving LBW. 407 then, a few players there might have liked to have gone on to bigger totals.
Gone. First ball, a half volley, and Hayden wasn't over the top of it. Nothing to do with the pitch. The pitch is as it was yesterday, and Hoggard has struck a magnificent blow. That was good footwork. Hunting got himself into the proper position there for the ball, short outside off stump.
Oh, that's a good shot, and it'll go for four. Ponting plays the pull shot as well as anyone in the game.
Now, there's a beautiful stroke. Fabulous. Supreme straight driving. Come on, it's a four ball. But Ricky Ponting has gone to a breathtaking 50 here at Edgbaston. Superlative stuff from the captain of Australia. It's in the back of his mind that he put England into bat, and people say he shouldn't have done. Clever shot. Oh.
That's out. Oh, yes, top edge. That's a big wicket. Giles has struck. Well, Ponting going for the little, what, it's a tentative shot, wasn't it? It's a little tentative sweep shot. He didn't really get stuck into it. It may just have flipped the edge of the rough there, hit the top edge of the bat, and it was a little lollipop.
Yes.
That's close. That's close. He's got to go to the third umpire for that. I think the direct hit very often ends up with a guy on his bike, but let's have a look at it.
Brilliant piece of fielding from Vaughan, who picks up at mid-on and recognises that it's Martin who's run into the danger end. Don.
This is going to be out. Yes, it is. That'll do for Michael Clarke. He gets enough on that. A strong feature of his game is the full face and back down past the bowler. And there's an aggressive stroke from Langer.
Justin Langer has got a half century. He's also got a few bruises out there, but it's been a good gutsy knock. And a very valuable one for the Australians.
That's a wonderful cover drive. Out of the textbook. Got him. That's a top-class bit of slow bowling from Ashley Giles. Change of pace does the trick. Warne got Strauss like that yesterday. Ball bowled much quicker. Now Giles has got Clarke.
Yeah, it was a quicker ball. Much flatter from Giles. And a fairly indeterminate stroke from Clarke, who'll be disappointed with himself.
Difficult batting, because Flintoff is hitting the deck. He's got the length right on this occasion, but it's been the Irish swing that has brought about a miscalculation from Simon Cadish.
Well, it's the control on this shot. How he rolls the wrist, that's the key.
Great shot. It's unusual for Andrew Flintoff to send down a half volley. He's a hit-the-pitch bowler.
Good, quick bowling. Oh, he's got him! What a swinger! Fast and full. Simon Jones deserves that. He's bowled a lot of good nuts today that haven't had reward. Now he's bowled one that has.
Cracking stroke through extra cover, and Jones is livid with himself. I don't think he needs to be.
Warney is gone.
It's a nice little battle for Ashley Giles to win, and a rather embarrassing one for Warne to lose.
Well, it wasn't much of a battle for Giles, was it? It was an absolute gift.
Good swinger again from Simon Jones. That ball moved away from the right-hander Lee, and it was neatly caught by Flintoff. That's a nice shot. Gillespie will suddenly produce one of those, almost from nowhere.
Like that. Yes, look at the finger. The slow death from Rudy Kutson. And maybe Tony Gregg should get out there and help Michael Vaughan with his job.
Oh, yes, that's that. Andrew Flintoff is very special. A big-hearted cricketer with a big, big performance for England today. Two in two. It leaves him on a hat-trick when he first bowls next time round. And Truscolic thumps him through extra cover. What a fabulous way to get going.
That is one shot from Trescothick.
And bowled him! How about that?
Absolutely brilliant from Shane Warne.
Magnificent piece of bowling from Warne. He's made a few batsmen look a bit foolish over the years, and there's no disgrace in Andrew Strauss looking a bit foolish, but he did here.
Was a wide one. He's found the outside edge. Nothing Truscothick will be pleased about there. It was a ball bowled at 88 miles an hour, just normal speed. Oh, a breakthrough. Well, Vaughan has looked as though that has kept low, but it just seemed to me that Lee beat him for pace. The quickest ball he's bowled this morning, it's just touching 90 miles an hour, and he was through the defence.
That's out. Well, it was so simple, Rich, that couldn't believe it.
Neatly taken. The night watchman really has got to stay out there the following morning, otherwise the scorecard takes a slightly frenetic appearance. It's 31 for four now.
Well, it's gone for that one. And it has gone, Miles. It's into the stands. Peterson, he likes to get on with it.
And again. This is a great display from Kevin Peterson. It's not just the fact that he's hit the two sixes, it's the decision-making and the ability to have a go.
What's that hit? Giving it out. Now, Peterson doesn't look happy. Peterson will reckon it hit his chest or some other part of his body, I wonder. But, Tony, you thought it was out immediately.
Well, it looked to me as if it hit the glove, but he's shaking his head. I don't like the fact that he's looking up at the screen.
What's happened here? Ow! Just a little thin one. What a bowler. A fantastic bowler.
He steered away to the boundary. That was well played. He was right over the top of that one. Oh, that's out. Yes, it's off the glove. Boy, that stood up. That really did surprise him. He's having a look down at the pitch. I've got to say that we haven't seen many bounce like that. That went from nowhere.
Well, that's the most difficult ball that anybody's had today to play.
That's a good shot. There are two men out there to cut off that stroke. And Flintoff. Well, it looks as though his shoulder's loosening up a bit. Neat. Made him play at that. Instead of the ball being down round about the line of leg stump, he has got it about middle and leg and produced the defensive stroke from Giles. And Hayden has taken the catch.
Got his revenge, Shane Warne. Ashley Giles, of course, did for Warne when Warne was batting, and now Warne has got this revenge. A beautifully pitched leg break.
And well, oh, and Jones has done it. He's got away for four, and that allows Flintoff to keep the strike. So that's clever cricket from Simon Jones. That has gone many a mile. Oh, biggie. Straight into the crowd. 50 for Flintoff. What a brave innings. And what a valuable one. It's 247 ahead now.
It's a heck of a good shot. And listen to the response of the crowd. I mean, this is... Oh, hello! Massive! Massive! One of the most magnificent strikes you'll ever see. Straight over the top of the stump. What a fantastic strike. Beautiful, straight, free-flowing bat. Oh, well, now. It's six more.
A bowled in. That's the end of that. Shane Warne has eventually got his man. So Warne ends up with 6 for 46. And he's now on 599 wickets.
The third afternoon in Birmingham, and already the final innings of the match begins. Australia need 282 to win the game.
Really good stroke. It was a pretty good bouncer from Harmison, quick and on target.
It's a super shot. The use of the feet did it, and then a lovely free swing at the back. It's a beautiful off drive. Lovely footwork, and then a full committed drive down the ground. Brilliant play from Langer. And so, after an excellent start by the Australians, they were 47 for no wicket. Michael Vaughan called on Freddie Flintoff in the 13th over. He was on a hat-trick, of course, after his first innings effort. He didn't get it, but...
Goal! He's got in! Freddie Flintoff! The man! Three wickets in four balls, but the breakthrough. That'll get him going.
That has got him going, and it also means that a right-hander will come in now. We have Ricky Ponting, the skipper, coming in at number three. But Flintoff has done it. He batted magnificently.
Oh, that's so close! And it's not out.
Oh, I say. Yeah, he's got outside the line again. Won't be a problem as far as Flintoff's concerned.
Beauty! Yes! Magnificent cricket from this man. Really. Really, he set the place alight. He's knocked the game on its head. Fantastic.
Big leg putter, big outside edge, and a fast nick. What an over. Ponting no score, and it's 48 for two.
It's a classic straight drive. It's the best of Hayden.
Oh, he's got it! Brilliant catch from Marcus Trzaskowski. It seemed to hang in the air, and so did Trzaskowski. And as he rolled over, he clung on. What a breakthrough.
I think it was the outswinger.
That is some shot. Oh, dear me. Brilliant batting this.
Oh, he's caught it as well. Hoggard strikes immediately. Bell is the man at mid-wicket who clings on. Martin is the man who has to walk back to the pavilion.
Well, that's well played. Oh, what a shot to get off the mark with. Oh, very good shot. He used his feet beautifully.
Yeah, yeah!
Got him! Got him! Beautifully taken. A little fumble there, but what a wicket. Well, Giles has done his stuff. He's come to the party. He's found the outside edge. And just for a second, I thought it was going to pop out.
Catch him! Yeah!
Gone. And so might be the match.
That's huge wicket. I know they're all big wickets, but getting Gilchrist out cheaply is big. Look at it. See, it just turns a bit, skews from the bat, a mishit. It's a simple catch. Ready, Flintoff. Pressure's got to him there, you know, to attack. 136 for six.
Oh, yes, that has got to be out. Fast delivery, 90 miles an hour.
Well, that was an absolute beauty, wasn't it? Right in the block hole, quick.
Six, what a shot. There he goes again. Another fabulous stroke from Shane Warne.
Oh, Stephen Harmison with a slower ball. One of the great balls. Given the moment, given the batsman, and given the match, that is a staggering gamble that's played off for Harmison. He bowled it perfectly.
That's gone wide of the man at deep third man. That's quite a useful stroke from Brett Lee. Now, this is the moment where Michael Vaughan has a bit of thinking to do.
Got him! Well done, Flintoff! Fast, full, straight, doing the business against Shane Warne. Freddie's pleased. You should see how 22,000 Brummies feel about it. And Lee goes big and gets four. 42 to win.
Well, you've got to give him credit for this shot. This is a super hit.
Now Casper goes over the top. That's a wonderful stroke. Well, superbly well played.
Oh, it's a full toss four. Way down the leg side. It beats the keeper and into the rope down there for four. 20 to win. Oh, inside edge for four. That's not what England wanted. Well, he steered that on away. Oh, and there's a dive down at third man. I reckon he got a hand on that. Jones came in. It would have been a great catch. Very difficult if you're driving forward in the outfield. No ball called. And four. He's gone for the Yorker. No ball. He bowled it extra fast. And it's gone screaming away fine.
I think they'll be quite happy with singles.
And he's done it well. It's hit him, knocked his bat out of his hand. He's called for the one. Casper Richards responded. It's 278 for nine. Good toss outside off. Dub meant to be the Yorker. The idea was okay. Has done it. Despair on the faces of the batsmen and joy for every England player on the field. Victory by two runs for England. Harmison has got the wicket. Casperidge has done what he thought was right, and Jones has somehow managed to scramble across and dive and get both hands around the ball to end one of the most thrilling games of cricket there's ever been.